Club basically started with me and John Monty after our departure from MOD. We recruited Jason Capola as the first. We met Reed through our manager, John, and Marsha Zazula. We got Pat, who thought he was gonna get a free ticket out of us. And when he saw us, I guess he blew him away and kind of stuck with us. And that's basically how Mindfunk formed.
I just think you can dance fight or fuck to it. We think our music's very sexual, but I think it just depends on the kind of mood you're in and the kind of mood we're in and how many people in the crowd are fucking with this and how many aren't. If they're having a good time, we're having a good time. If they're not, we're not, you know? This band does have aggressiveness, but it's positive aggressiveness. And that's a power and an intensity which we bring to the stage especially, and we try to produce on the record and the videos as well.
We did it more for like the kids and for the clubs, and like when people go out to see a show, when they show videos in a club, it had more of that atmosphere than like say on like an MTV or a video show like that. We wanted it much harder and heavier and raw edge type of thing.
They had me jumping off a high dive and like my boots like all like 5 layers of clothing with holding onto the chain, and they didn't want me just to jump in and then come up. They wanted me to twist around under there, and then after we got it back, they used about 3 seconds of it. And I would come up for air, and a couple times I really got scared that I was gonna drown.
At L Sound Studios in Copenhagen, Denmark.
If you listen to the Mindfuck album and read the lyrics, it's just basically about American society. It's just wrapped up in a big ball, and I think that all came together after we saw how other people lived in other countries. And it's a sad note, but it's just like when we were in Denmark walking down the street at 4 in the morning, people are like, you can't do that. And we're like, shit, man, this is Disneyland compared to where we live. You know what, your biggest crime is bike theft? It's like, we don't have to worry about getting shot around here.
Like when we went to Denmark and we would go into, they had this place, Christiania, where you can go and like get whatever you wanted as far as like, you know what I'm saying, like as far as party material, as far as party material, as far as party material. And we would always, when we went there, we would always have our guard up, but people were like really nice and they would just be giving it to you like, here, take more, and in New York they just give you fake stuff and it's like, that's why you never buy it over there.
If we ever got to the point where we could really call the shots, we would call it Mindfuck again, because that's what it's all about, you know. It's we write trippy music and trippy lyrics that fuck with your head, and that's what we're about, you know. Burn this mind and body down and down and down. Just burn your mind.